Hello. Hello and good evening. Yeah, it really is like a 47-year-old learning to type. To write. You have duplicates, right? Not similar as a 5, similar to 6, because... What are we talking about? They gave us such bad code. Isn't every code kind of bad code? Exam tomorrow. That's fine. That's completely fine. I'm not sure what we're gonna do today. I mean, I wanna add scripting, obviously, but other than that, so just resize that. Okay, that works. Yeah, have fun lurking. So, as you all can see, my keyboard arrived. And it's a massive pain. I can't tell you enough how much of a pain that is. You can't see that? I mean, I can show you. I can try to show you. I'll not show you. We need pixel, it didn't happen. The thing is, the cabling I did is not fit for showing stuff to the camera. So... yeah, you just have to believe me on that one. Also, you will see how bad it is when I start typing. Okay, where am I? Will recognize the typos? Yeah. So let me check. Go to CD hard. No. It's getting better by the day, but it's yeah, it is frustrating. So no projects. Rust hardbot. One thing I want to do today is allow multiple processes of the bot to run, so I can have one version on each of my desktops. Yeah, so it begins. It's like I said, it's insanely hard. Also, I recognize all the mistakes or how I'm using the keyboard wrong. So I'll for instance, the B key I always pressed with the right hand, which is apparently wrong. I do press the D key and the C key with my index finger. And I think that's because of gaming, actually. Because while gaming, your hand is shifted one to the left because of WASD, and your pinky finger sits in control. And that's my actual neutral for typing. And so if I want to do a D, I'm trying to press it with my index finger. I'm trying to unlearn that. It's gonna be so hard. So source, main. The only thing that's positive is because it's a switch to German. My tab key and my shift key and stuff is already in the correct place. But the worst thing is gonna be special characters. So I do know how to make braces. So I can go to my second mode and press J for normal. And I can go to my second mode and press M for the curly braces. You. One mistake I made. Tried not to move my hand, just my fingers. Kind of works, but super tiresome. I struggle with braces a lot. So the last few minutes, or last few minutes, the last hour at work, I switched to my old keyboard because I needed to get stuff done, and I can't just... Hey, Edwin Chang! And I can't just guess my way Yeah. So there's that. But I didn't find it tiring, so I used it almost the whole day since noon. Since noon. And I didn't find it especially tiring. But if you type with one character per minute, let me try something. Can I show you one half? I probably can show you one half. So here is one half of my keyboard. The only thing that really bothers me is the wrist rests, because they smell so insanely bad. I needed to put them away. I added that as a channel point event. Yeah, let's wait a day or two, and then maybe I'll do that as well. Just go to monkey. That's the wrong button. Monkey type. Okay. At least you can you can actually configure that with, where's my delete button? Language. Do they smell of plastic or such? They are rubber, some kind of rubber, and they do have a really chemical smell to them. So they probably, because they're new and just produced. So code C is where it's at, right? Just use my mouse here. 10 words. How do I set 10 words? Change word count. Let's do that. 10. Punctuation enabled. Oh boy. The thing is, because I'm seeing it right now, stuff is in the time extreme. Yeah, because I'm seeing it right now, let's use my mouse. So the angle brackets, I currently have angle brackets on thumb buttons, and I'm thinking about switching them so that my left thumb button is the greater sign and the right thumb button is the less than sign, and use that for indentation in Vim. Anyway, so what? Double punctuation. I don't know where all these characters are. Okay, I'm gonna not see chat for a moment because I need my helper thingy. Okay, so this is break space f open space while space. Where's my equals? I have no idea. Can't even find it. Okay, let's do the old way. Equals space exit semicolon free semicolon. This that space, wow, main s print f type the 9 words per minute. All the settings are at the top right corner. Oh yeah, yeah, yeah. But you can also press I'm in the wrong window. Let's go to... You can do escape two times, and then you can type what you actually want to change. So you can do language, enter, and do code C. I mean, I'm not right sure if it's code C. Yeah, I accidentally pressed escape. It also sometimes doesn't quite work. But that's fine. So code. Let's see. Hey, Geralt. One more monkey type. Okay, I mean, that one should be easy. Punctuation and numbers should be enabled. So, okay, so void space F open do what? Space double CMP four dot scan. F scan F. I mean, it's kind of okay for the first day. I should actually. Yeah, I should actually sign in someday. One more. Okay, why can I do? Okay, whatever. Exit case dot dot EOF. Print F while realloc case for dot oh I mistyped else semicolon static dot better. Yeah, I kind of pressed escape instead of shift because my caps lock is escape. Hey, Nipsey. Yeah, fast typers anonymous. No. How are you doing? I also think I really find strange is if I have my right hand on the keyboard, my thumb naturally goes to the inner button. So wait, let me ergodocs. Let me go to the actual tool. So that's also the ergodocs mouse I'm using. So it's way worse than I thought. So even though you said it's way worse than you thought, I still thought, well, it can't be that bad. So let's go down here. Oh, I hate this side. But if you want to use the mouse, just make it a bit slower, and then it's quite usable. So, well, that's obviously my keyboard. So if I go to JC, hey Tamiluka, go to mouse mode. So I just made everything a bit slower and made it so that it took longer. Yeah, it took longer for the max speed. I will decrease this by one, I think. But for now, it's okay. I mean, if you like, we can just flash the keyboard as well. It's really not hard. although during my first flash, I almost bricked the keyboard. So I tried to get the German layout, and while pressing the reset button, I kind of pressed it twice and aborted the whole thing, and then my keyboard wouldn't work. So okay, oh, another thing, the keyboard is making my hands dry. But that's the plastic, that's normal with new plastic. Okay, rust, almost. Rust, better dry hands than sweaty hands. That's true. I mean, you can do something for dry hands. There is, I use this. Not sponsored, by the way, since I think a month or two. Wait, I should actually do search terms as well. Rust, get process list. I know that's not the most Linux way to do that, the most Unix way. Raid Shadow Legend hand cream. Yeah, it's just a good hand cream. Okay, do not want to spawn a process, I want to get a process. Or Skillshare hand cream, or Audible. Audible, yeah, you can listen to hand cream for hours on end. So that's not what I want. Process list. SA. I need to train myself to not move my pinky finger to control and leave it at A. Rust, get running no pros, no processes. Don't forget ExpressVPN hand cream, it keeps you private. Well, okay, no. Is there no library to get all the processes, all the running processes? Someone shields, I'm loving this. Can recognize my own struggle. If someone shills a VPN, they usually get an unfollow no matter if I liked them before or not. This makes me a bit scared to build a split keyboard. Yeah, don't be scared. I mean, you're gonna be more productive because with the keyboard you can't actually open toggle stream. So you can't type, so you can't open the Twitch stream. Have you tried NSA VPN? That's why I'm learning Vim and Rust at the same time. Yeah, get a split keyboard as well. Just for the lulz. Should we really do a log file? I'm kind of not a big fan of log files. Yeah, Colmac is better than Dvorak. I've actually no idea, I've never used any of them, but whatever. Okay. Do we just call PS and be done with it? Learning Vim and split keyboard might actually be a great idea. You will notice the lack of speed when you just start with a Vim. True. I mean, you have to think what you press anyway. No muscle memory issues. I mean, I have muscle memory issues from 15 years of using Windows. But whatever. Rust. Proc. List. Well, switch to work, a call max to get rid of those muscle memories too. Yeah, then I can't type anything. Just want a process list. How do you get a process list in Linux? Can't be that hard, right? There needs to be a crate for that. List. Processes. Oh, I actually pressed the wrong button once. Vim is so easy to configure, I don't know if there is an advantage. It's the decades of staggered QWERTY that is the real fight. Soon he will be 2 words per minute. Do you mean I already did 7? I wanna list all running processes, yeah. True, I did 13. But 13 isn't as funny as 7. Maybe it was characters per minute. Okay, so process list. ID and name. Why is the name path? Or is it the exe name? Does that work on Windows as well? For now, only Windows is supported. Huh. I mean, it's about ergonomics anyway, not speed. I don't even write that much code. Is there a PS crate? We could check that out. Control T. Crates. Crates. Crate. PS. I'm mostly editing, removing, etc. Let's use that. Let's lose the philosopher's stone to get our processes. I type all day long. I mean, I'm a working programmer. I do write much code, but most of the time for me is actually spent thinking about the code. It's mostly talking to stream chat though. Okay. let's go here. Let's do PS. Let's see if we find something. Save wraparound transmute. I'm doubting that it's actually safe, but whatever. So fixed map, faster, sorting explorer. A process list plugin for new shell. Hey, what does that use? The real struggle for me is before new keyboard, I didn't have to spend any time thinking about typing. Now I spend time trying to type and I'm very frugal with words. Yeah, I mean, I don't know if you have that, but I try, how do I say this? A few years back, I was trying to get good in Counter-Strike and really trained myself to have good aim and stuff. Then I didn't play for a few years. And I think last year or 2 years ago, I tried to get back. Well, not at the same level, just kind of good. And every time I started to train, if my hand has to do movements it's not used to, I get a very, very strange feeling. And yeah, I just want to stop doing whatever I'm doing. On a Smurf, I went to Supreme with the only solo queue. Wow, nice. I mean, I never actually got to Supreme, so. Is there no source code for that? Okay, let's go to the next page. Partial script. Modern replacement for procs. Let's try that. What happened? But now I suck. I don't think I could keep up with modern LEM full gear. I mean, I would kind of like to start playing again, but no matchmaking, just 10 mans with friends would be fine. But almost everyone I know is just, let's play matchmaking all day. And yeah, that's not for me. So. Okay, but how dear procs, how do you work? Repository. Let's go to the cargo tumble. Dependencies. Procfs. Use walk deer. I mean, as the thing is, I would use, I would lose cross-plat capabilities while doing that. I mean, I could kind of use that. I mean, want. You could just do the proc for the lols. What does actually happen if you do that? I know you can remove the whole system. It's the wrong button. That's the right button. I mean, the other thing we could do is just define a log file. And get rid of that in the main script. That should work as well, right? So let's control C. Oh, by the way, Fluffy, are you still here? Do you still hear me? Just a small thing, because you said you wanted a moon lander too. Just came back. Good timing. So, if you buy a moon lander or anything from Ergodox, you will need to pay import costs. So I think for me it was about 60 euro you will pay on top of the whole price package. Just so you know. I'm aware. Okay, good. I mean, that's the price of healthy typing. That would have rinsed me out. So the dollar sign, it's more than... I paid 60 euros. I would have rather paid $60 because that would be cheaper. Okay, let's actually do something. What just happened? Undo. Thank you. Okay, so where is everything handled? Spawn thread, it already does all this stuff, including saving. Okay, so let's go to the start, let's go to main. That's not main. That's main. Can I somehow... Twelve, two, three. What light bulb for 150 will still take a while to offset the cost. I'm not quite sure following. Wait, is there actual? Let's check if that exists. Rust lock file. Great. Yeah, I'm also kind of confused. This crate provides a log file structure that marks the location the file system is locked. Lock is conceptually created when the file is created and released when it's deleted. The file is. A lock file that cleans up after itself. That's it. I'm not sure if it does. I mean, I think Tommy Luco is telling me to get a different light bulb. I think that's what he wanted to tell me, right? I was talking about myself. Okay. I just switched it. Oh, nice. It's like a year ago. Okay, go back. This crate contains support for creating lock files as are used in various Unix type systems. Blah blah blah. Okay, I think I missed something. Just switched. If it's burning for 24 hours, it would take 24 days to offset the cost. I mean 24/7. You save money, you should never turn off the lights. Quickly restart my laptop, be right back. Okay, have fun restarting your laptop. Okay, so I'm gonna just use that for now. Gonna use my cool keyboard mouse. Hopefully. No, we don't need that. What did I do? No. Bad keyboard. Okay, that's exclamation mark cargo add dot lock loco dot loco. That's what I wanted to type. Dot lock, yeah. Okay. Well, the bulb is in my office where it's on for about 8 hours a day in total. It's about 3.5 to 4 months. I do get that though. So my light bulb is almost on almost the whole day when I'm working, because if the lighting isn't perfect, not perfect, but if you have bad lighting, it's actually very bad for your eyes. But I have a Jetted Deer where the light bulbs are a bit more expensive. Oh, okay, got it. Yeah, that makes sense. That actually makes sense. I have one light bulb. And like I said, it's always on. Because when I open the window, I'm actually blind. So. Let... log file equal no dot log what? Dot log create. We have a huge old house, loads of lights, each bedroom generally has 5 to 6 light bulbs, both living rooms are the same. Yeah, so it makes sense to change to something cheaper. Okay, got that. I didn't want to press enter here. That is locked equals lock file dot is okay. Do you guys know a method of maximizing the minimum Hamming function? What is a Hamming function? Let's start with what is a Hamming function. Oh, is it Hamming distance? That would be by not using it. Okay. Don't think that's the thing you want, right? It's probably not the Hamming window, it's just the Hamming distance. Or is it the Hamming window? Well, yes, but no. That doesn't answer my question, actually. So, which is it? Is it both? Do we need to look at both? Let's go back here. Well, maximizing the minimum Hamming would make no sense as it's contradicting itself. That's probably true, because I have no idea what you're actually talking about. Could you clarify, SpaceFox, what you're trying to do? We give the task to use 8 bits and code 6 symbols and need to find the max Hamming for it. Oh, so you need to find the maximum Hamming distance for a six for an 8-bit encoding with six symbols. Okay, let's go to C. Being bot with the raid. Hi everyone. Wait, 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 wait. Let's do. You get your own command, being bot. How's that? They will take your emojis, being bot. Did the same thing again. What? No, 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 no. Go back, go back, go back. I said go back. We'll do C. Also, excuse my slow typing. I just got an Ergodox today. Yeah, just got an Ergodox today, and I'm really, really slow. So, distance. Tia Flow, thanks for the follow. It's very, very nice of you. Gotta go, Hardliner. Take care. Yeah, take care, Tamaluka. I'm Austrian, so I'm almost German. Let's go to edit. Where's my tilde key? Do I have a tilde key? I have. That's here. Okay. Let's go back. Let's go to one. Yeah, like I said, I'm pretty confused right now because of the keyboard stuff. Dot config hardbot config. Gonna add a new command somewhere. Wait, that's not what I wanted to do. Paste is what I wanted to do. Change in word. Gonna do keyboard. Oh boy, unlearning all the bad habits. It's using an flex. Where is my set key? What did I do? Here's my set key. Get rid of that. Get rid of that. Get rid of that. Save. Close that. Now I should be able to just make the space. The bot will do nothing because it doesn't actually compile. Okay. GCC, save that. Come on, bot, do your thing. Yeah, I'm using Manjaro because I'm too lazy to set up Arch the right way. Let's get that, let's get that. Oh, it needs a file. OP Helia 6277, thanks for the follow. It's two follows, let's get some hype going. Wait, does it need anything? Is that some file.log? It does. So let's do okay, what did I miss? Apparently you can convert Manchero to normal arch, never tried it though. And I will hydrate. Today I'm gonna check out if the store is ready. Because we should actually be able to get the new link now. And then you can get your own Giggle Juice cup. Since it's based on that, I would assume you can. Yeah, just uninstall everything. Mine is on the way. Nice. Okay, where is everything? Let's do dot hard. Wrong button again. Hard. Yeah, just take that. Dot lock. Is it correct now? So that's not used, that's fine. No, not is locked. That's not the wrong word. Is second. Oh, now I know what I pressed. So second instance. And if we have a second instance. Yeah, should I do a mouse command where it also prints them using an ergodox? Oh, wrong direction. So does the bot need to know? I think the bot needs to know, right? So yeah, the bot needs to know. Okay. Hello. Is the bot gone? No. Well, it works now. Where is my bot? Where is my bot? Where is my bot? Here is my bot. Go to definition. You're gonna take second instance value, which is I hate that so much. Go to definition. Which is a boolean. Every time I try to press B, I actually press page down. Yeah, lurking works. You should always be able to lurk. Wait, that's the button. Un-unlurk. Have fun lurking. OK. Okay, so let's go here. Actually pass the second instance. Also, if you're tired of Bob PogChamp changing every day, you can just subscribe. That's not what I wanted to type. You can subscribe and get PogChamp, which is way superior to the normal PogChamp. Firstly, it doesn't change. Secondly, it's awesome. And it's a giggle, so don't want to miss out on a giggle, right? I'm kidding. That's a cool dog emote. Okay, we have a second instance now. Let's go to the bot. We need to store that. So we'll pop semicolon. If second instance, this is gonna so destroy everything. Nothing will work. Okay, where are my brackets? Here they are. If second instance, just return none. Back insert self. That's not a self. That's a self. Okay, so does it still work? No, it's gone now. Oh, wait. Have I told you to wait already? Is error. That's the correct one. We're only a second instance if you're error. So let's DC again. And it does nothing. Why? Okay, S gonna stretch in a second. Dot output lock. Remove that. Be gone. And recompile. Okay, stretching is done. Now let's try again. Let's do debug. Paste. Didn't actually debug print, but why? Okay, Count processes, not company. We want to do Hardbot. Hello. One. Okay. Let's P kill. Let's P kill Hardbot. Tico. Now we have zero. Let's go to our project. Remove the log file. Split output. Okay, so now this version should actually DC write something, right? Okay, it does. Let's resize. So if I rebuild now, what happens? So now we have two bots running. And both of them answer. The one thing they shouldn't do. Okay, let's go one up. Make another window. That wasn't quite what I expected. That was what I expected. So let's count processes. There were two running. Oh, because I actually didn't kill the bot last time. So we pkill 9 the bot. Now there should be no bots running, right? So is there seed? What? No. Yes. Cat. So there is no log file now. Good. I open. Okay. So now there should be one bot running and the one bot should respond accordingly. See? Okay. Now if I cargo run the second bot, why is it okay though? Anybody understanding this? still needed. I think the library doesn't do what I wanted to do. Currently only one type is writer lock file. It does not destroy the file after closed and behavior unlocking different file handles owned by the same process is different between Unix and Windows. I mean, how to use the file as lock, supports not the standard crates but the sibling standard. That doesn't make sense. Okay. Let's count our processes again. That's the wrong kind of process I want to count our processes again. Zero. So we're not gonna do that. Get rid of that. Get rid of that line. Get rid of that line. Second. Oh, come on. Here's my enter key. Let's take that, remove it, write. Is the purpose to prevent multiple instances running? No. The idea was to allow multiple instances to run, but make only one instance handle messages. So right now, if I just start the bot two times and you'll write exclamation mark DC. Wait, let's recompile. No recompile. Okay, that window's gone. And where was I? Yeah, so I just want to make one bot handle all the messages and all the commands, and every other bot that started after that should just show the message. So let's count. Hey, they're still running. Let's pkill. And let's split output. Yeah, so I could, if I got this running, just check if it is running. PC. Yeah, so if I got that running, I could do one instance on this desktop, one instance on that desktop, one instance on the third desktop, and so on and so forth. So no matter where I am, I still can show you, I can show the messages on screen. That key? No, that key. Okay, the next thing is scripting. So instead of hard coding every function, I think it would be better to just allow the user to set custom functions as a script. But for that, we actually need to handle storage as well. So if message, if not message starts with exclamation mark. So in here, we need to we need a way for the script to tell us which handlers it provides. Or we can do one script per handler so that you can configure, let's say hype will call the script hype dot whatever whatever kind of script language you choose. So let's go for Rust. Rust scripting. Probably something like Rai. I think we'll probably just embed Rai itself. Let's see, you can register functions, you can evaluate a file. I think I might do what do I think I want to do? I think we'll use one script for everything and create a way to register commands from inside the script. I think that makes sense. Hey MegaFox, how are you doing? Should we? Okay, let's start that in another project first and then we'll move it. So cargo new, cargo new, write test CD. That's wrong. Okay, so wait, don't I have a cargo add? Yeah. Write enter. Now, still way too fast. So that was the Agadox mouse I just used. Shift V, enter, escape. What do you mean? I just cargo added it. Cargo build. In the meantime, we'll get the rest. Oh, come on. I'm gonna do that shortly. It's strange to control your mouse with the keyboard. Let me tell you that. still compiling. So, okay, let's do the stretch. Stretch and hydrate. Oh. Let's do it. Yeah, dude, please crash. Also, I'm thinking about doing a little bit less today, because I do need to look up a few things. Wait. And I'm not sure how that goes in stream, so I don't want to do crazy stuff while learning crazy, crazy keyboards. Cargo build again. Yeah, it is. It's insane, actually. So, cargo run, and it won't run because there is no script, right? Yeah. So we'll just name that bot. I mean, I can tell you what I wanna do or need to do. I wanna check out Substrate. It gets easier every day. I mean, after using it today, I already said I switched back to my old keyboard for work because I needed to get stuff done, and I was already confused at my old keyboard. So, once I do learn, I kind of learn very fast, but yeah. What? Can I? I hate this so much. I already talked with Teach about that. That I want the function where you can just open a folder and it directly goes into Telescope. Which would be insanely cool. But I think he wants to just change. He wants to implement the window. Should be able to do that. Yeah, I tried and I failed miserably. And he said he wants to not get rid of, but make a normal window instead of a floating window for something like that. Can you launch Telescope as an EX command? Is there a reason all CPP Rust programmers are going bald on Twitch? I mean, if it helps, I was bald before I started Rust programming. Also, if you want a non-balding Rust programmer, you can check out Togglebit stream, who has more than enough hair. No, I actually started balding at 17, which is, let me think, 14 years ago? It's a week. Yeah, so... what do I want to do? Edit. Okay, so... Telescope. Next. I did not answer. Okay, so there should be a telescope somewhere. Yeah, so telescope find files. This is what I've bound to leader FF to open that thing. So that's the thing I actually want to show. And the thing I tried. And I tried many things. No, I didn't try many things. I tried this. check for browse, which is was kind of stolen somewhere. So you can find aperture strength, but I hate it. Oh, the hemming distance stuff. Or am I missing some context? So check for browse. Yeah, so the basic idea. Okay. Yeah, so the basic idea was to on Vim enter or buff enter, check if we are a directory. If not, return, because if you open a file, you don't need it. And then just call the telescope thing. But I could probably just do a normal. Wait, where's the find? Find files. Can't I just take that whole string? And put that into a normal? Paste, something like that? Shouldn't that work? I mean, if there is no other way than to... Oh, that did work. Okay. Let me try to quit first. So vim minus c telescope find files, and I can't actually believe to type that I've typed that without looking and without error. Yeah, I can do that. So let's edit the right file as well. And I'm back to mistyping again. Yeah, that was correct. So shouldn't I be able to do that in here? So GCC that. Something like that. Don't know if all plugins has to be loaded before you do that, maybe. That is possible. So let's just try it. Yeah, that didn't work. Okay. Find. Just do it as a fish function. Yeah, but I need it when I run it with an argument. I mean, I could still do that. Could still do that. I could. Let's get just rid of that, because that's not needed anymore. Then we see config.fish. Also, my Vim complains about my fish config, even though it's completely fine. Doesn't even show any errors, so. Yeah, the two just remove the fish plugin. So I could. Let's get a function going. Function v. Almost end. Don't create functions here, why not? There should be a directory called functions. Is that so? I mean, I have no idea how to use fish. And if you Google fish, if you Google, fish function, that's what you get. Just look at the directory where you have your fish config. Okay. Let's do that. CD config fish. So that's the thing I have right now. Add a directly called functions. Yeah, why though? I don't understand why. I can absolutely do that. That's not the problem. Is it the fish best practice, or because the thing I have on the left works perfectly fine? Yeah. Okay. Okay, let's go to the other directory. CD scripts. Oh boy, it's gonna be so much struggle. So I'm gonna make a function directory and probably one file per function. A fish and other function called hello that just echoes hello. Okay, so let's do we hello dot fish. And in here, I'm gonna do new function hello echo hello and. Okay. Let's save, let's quit. Oh. If it doesn't work, just run fish to load the shell. Yeah, I need to copy it first. So I just try to run it in the correct. Just do it in the correct folder. So fish enter hello. Did not work. What am I doing? Are you in config fish? It gets automatically copied. So currently I'm in my scripts folder. and everything inside of config gets copied into the write.config folder. So everything in config fish gets copied into .config fish. And we can check it as well. Where's my tilde again? Wait. Oh, that button. Okay. So that button slash. Oh boy. Config fish. And here's my functions. Functions function. I'm actually stupid. That's the problem. Okay. Copy hello into functions. Now do delete, go back again, and update. Okay, so now I should be able to do fish and hello. Almost. Okay. Got it. So VC. Functions. VC functions. Let's do VC.fish. No. No umlaut a. Now let's take that. Yank. Go to the right. That, go to the right, just paste that. Is there anything missing? No, probably not. So that should mean I should be able to take that out. And it should still work. Let's update everything. Go to fish. See if we can still VC. Okay, so that still works. So the next thing we'll do is the V fish, which is no colon plus yank. I have a feeling that wasn't yank. Well, as long as it kind of works. So GCC. Now let's edit config fish functions VC. PC is kind of slow today. Don't know why. So let's get that. Plus Y. So if we have more, if you have more than zero arguments, else just NVIM. Okay. Oh wait. If I do it like that, I would need to pass all the arguments and check if we actually wanna open a directory. I mean, okay, let's do it the other way around. Let's just do it every time. But if we do it every time, I can just make it an alias, right? So we can remove config bish functions v. No, the other one. That's gonna be minus C. I think I need to backslash here. How do I backslash? It's my pinky. That? No. That? No. Oh, A. My A key. Telescope. Wait, couldn't I just use hey Hagask, thanks for the follow. Undo. Can't I just use those? Delete that. So it was telescope find file. Oh yeah, files. No, find files quotes. Here is delete. Okay. Just remembered where my delete button is. Okay, so we'll do the same thing for that. But without that, without the space, right? Okay, let's see if it did work. Let's do we dot. Nope. Oh, makes sense. Let's fish first. And now we'll V dot. Cool. So now I can do main. Can I get rid of this thing, whatever that is? Directory listing. Can I not open that somehow? Mr. Togglebeat, you could probably know that. Oh, what? So I did the alias thing. Now telescope opens correctly, but in the background there's still the directory listing. Can I somehow get rid of that? Sorry, I was busy not being a lawyer. I'm busy not being a lawyer every day. Yeah, that's not the default behavior. Okay. So we should... should go to our init file, probably. Now the question is what and why? I can't remember installing anything that would do that though. If you run NVIM, does it open? Okay, wait. Not an alias or anything, just straight up exit the binary. I can do NVIM dot. And then we'll open netRW. If I do... if I do just NVIM, it does not. But if I do just V, it does, because I told it to do that. But it's the directory parsing. That's the problem. So if I run it without the directory, it will just do the right thing. RW settings. Uh-huh, okay. What even is that? It's for control. Win95 FTP, that's important. Better not disable that. Probably some kind of dependency of some kind of plugin. If you run Vim with dot source, then it will open another W. However, since you control the arg in your alias, you could just remove that. I don't know, actually. So... If I would know how, I would do that. Okay, since when does Control T not move you to the address thing? Okay, let me refresh the change your alias to something like VT. Oh, what do you mean? Yeah, but it's not a problem with the alias. The thing is, if I do, for instance, V source, it does the same thing. And that's the thing I don't want to happen. So, let's wait, execute that again. Okay, well, the telescope also isn't working. Can't you just disable that? Wait. Net RW, okay. Disable. Disable. Vim. Yeah, I have not added it. Okay. Okay, let's try something. So what I wanted to try. Vim netRW. Ships with Vim in this default browser. Okay. So maybe this is what you want. Let G loaded W. Okay, so that disables it. We got a spy. Let's see if we can just disable file browser stuff on start. Are there some settings somewhere? Settings. Okay, transfer control, messages, browser controls. Okay, so where is actually my F1 key? Oh. On the layer far away, sadly, yes. So I need to do that. Disable that. Slow speed directory browsing. Yeah, that's not what I want. The thing is, what is the banner? That's what I want to know. Okay, the banner's the top part of NetRW. Okay, got it. We see the hub and shortcuts. Okay, so I do want that if I use it. Hmm. And I didn't miss anything, right? Come on. Go back. Nine. C, the W, disable, disable, start. When I don't want to completely get rid of it. Okay, so that's that, it's just a banner. Let's see what Reddit. Listening to them, if you want to listen to. Yeah, I don't want to do that. Let's try that. Well, let's just try it. Quit VC init. I need to clean everything up someday. Right, quit we dot enter easy. Simple as that. With the power of Googling and a little bit of Reddit help. Okay, let's see. Yeah, I think I'm gonna call it for today. We didn't do anything alt related actually, which is kind of sad. Does it work to open files now? You mean with colon E? So source, wait, source main does still work. If you mean for, oh, from telescope. Let's try that again. Enter main. Yeah, it does work. So we fixed that. Yeah, either. You mean big E? What does big E do? You mean like that? Yeah, does work. Okay, just show off. I should show you the solution again, which is stolen. wait, what am I actually searching? Yes, that's it. Just you can probably call that. No. Here's my plus. What? Why can't I? Oh, I'm in the wrong mode. That's why I can't do anything. So can I do file explore? Okay. Oh, it clears the autogroup file explorer. Now I get it. Okay. Yeah, but like I said, I'm gonna call it quits for today. I need to do a little bit of research, and I'm gonna do that off stream. And tomorrow we'll actually add the thing we wanted to add. Yeah, thanks for watching. For everyone who hasn't, when I use Super Mario again. Next week, and not the coming weekend, but the weekend after that. So this weekend I'm gonna take the weekend off, and the weekend after that we'll do Super Mario again. Yeah, so for everyone else, if you like, you can join my Discord, where we can talk, do cool stuff. We also have the Rust Station bot installed, which allows you to try code samples for some languages. Yeah. And now we should actually check who we want to raid. So there is a cool... Wait. There's a cool tool. That someone wrote. Here's Control C. Yeah, I think we raided him yesterday as well. So we'll do. Yeah, so some very cool person wrote the Twitch search stuff. You can find him at under the pseudonym Togglebyte on GitHub. Raid him again, we need more Rust. Yeah. So raid. Not the Shadow Legends kind. Will we enter? Okay, so again, thanks everyone for watching, and I hope we'll see each other tomorrow. Have a good evening, and bye.